leave that up to Sam. You can break all the bad news. I know I broke it inadvertently, but she can explain how this happened. I would say I'm sorry, but your kids got us into some mighty, mighty fun. Oh, it's that fucking dinosaur. Pete, I need a moment. The sound of crying children triggers me. No, don't touch the dinosaur. Not with those bloody ass hands, Michonne. You're gonna ruin it. Oh, I like that schism. So wait, was that your husband, brother-in-law? I believe those were the two walkers that were being kited, or that Michonne kited around for a while. Wow, didn't even have like the animation of slowly walking up. Elodie.
You girls in here?
Maybe. Oh. Elodie's name. Alright, so they both shared a bedroom? Ooh, what do we have here? Kid sneaker. Heck, this has been the most game that this game has been for quite some time, except for like the QTEs, but just mainly focused on the story. Which, you know, I'm not saying is a bad thing, but it's just a hell of a break in between the experiences, the story, and that. Alright, so the painting or the paint splotch? Let's take a look at the paint splotch. Never getting this out of the rug. Your grandmother knitted this rug. You goddamn children. It's dry. Uh-oh. Well, I want to take a look at the painting. Thank you for giving me the opportunity and chance to do... Come on. Oh, it's a tiger. A lion. No, it's more of a tiger. Pretty birds. Let's see. So follow the footsteps. Look at the family photo here. I have a husband with Elodie and Claudette. Her name is Claudette, right? That's a hell of a name. Look at the window. World's really gone to shit. What the fuck would I put a hole like that through the window, though? Corpse? Oh yeah, this was the batch of walkers I kicked the shit out of here. I don't know if I want to go through... No, the bedroom, that's not what I want to take a look at quite yet. I want to do a good loop of the room, I think. I would imagine. Or depending if the footsteps keep going further. Ooh, burned you up real good, motherfucker. No, I can't keep following those footsteps. Okay, gonna check on that bedroom then. It's a matter of progression or just checking shit out. Girls, are you hiding in Mommy and Daddy's room? Because if you are, then... Well, you're not gonna be in trouble. But... I would really be happy if... you're safe. Safety above all else. Take a look at the mirror. See if the mirror actually does real-time reflections. Nope! Reflections are hard. Remember that. No matter what you do. Your bedroom's goddamn pigsty. If there is a prompt to open up that shower curtain... Okay. Let's take a look at the bandages. But the colored footsteps. Colored footsteps definitely have to... This is a red herring. This is leading me to something that's not. The girls aren't dead in the tub. Or maybe they are. Excellent. I knew those footprints had to lead to where I need to be. That goddamn... I told my husband not to bring this fucking rubber ducky in the bedroom anymore. That's weird. It's not sexual aid. It's just creepy. God damn. It's the first kind of sign of, you know, a cityscape being all fucked up. Now, Frank Grimes woke up in a small Alabama? Georgia? Yeah, a small Georgian town. Or is Alabama in Georgia? Oh, wait, no, Georgia's its own state. Holy fuck. Ooh, I just said something real stupid. Damn. Mutilated corpse. That was my fine doing as well, I believe. Damn. Even saw the, like, top of the spine there. Rolling suitcase. It's like the girls were packed and ready to get the fuck out of here. That was my little girl's go bag. As long as the little girls didn't go in the bag. Ooh, they're alluding to it. No, just they're pretty close.
You left this all behind.
Well. Great. Hit the trigger point where the phone's ringing. But who? Who would be calling at a time like this? Oh, that's going to only gather or gain attention of things that don't really want to encounter. Answer the phone so it stops making noise so it doesn't draw in shit that don't want to have to deal with.
Michonne, it's Donna.
Who the fuck is...
Donna?
Donna.
I'm trying to get a hold of their dad. Are the girls with you?
I don't know where they are. No one's answering. Half the lines are disconnected.
No, they're not. I'm alone here.
When no one was picking up, I thought... God, I didn't even want to say it. I talked to Dominic earlier, but there was screaming. Christ, it was horrible. I don't know if it was him or who, but God, Michonne, he sounded so scared.
Dominic and Dion?
Crying. I couldn't stand it. Poor things, they must be terrified.
Donna, what did he say?
He said something about a bike. That his neighbor was bitten.
Okay, that's good.
Dominic tried to bandage him up, but his neighbor attacked him.
And bit him too?
We have to find them. They could be anywhere. And if we can't get a hold of them, what do we do?
I'm gonna keep searching.
I'm gonna keep searching here.
Hey, what are you... Oh, please,
don't. Yeah, no matter what I said, it wouldn't make a difference. Donna, get out of there!
Get out of there now! Donna! Who's Donna?
Oh, that could have been a little bit better if it pulled into the side of her head a little bit more.
Did you say Donna?
Yeah, I believe I did. The fuck's it to you? You guys have a phone? I know it doesn't work, but...
Okay?
Just remembering somebody.
Just thinking about someone I once knew.
It's okay. I do that too.
Not quite the way I do it, though. It's not that my way's better, it's just...
John, he... He went to talk to the kids, make sure they're all right.
John's the father.
Well, I watched over you.
How long was I out?
Sorry about this. John isn't big on people he doesn't know.
Oh, the children.
How are the kids holding up?
I don't know. Can't be good. Their brother's dead, sister's shot. I mean, fuck, right?
So who are you out of this whole situation? Not that it really matters, but just curious.
So, yeah. This is where I apologize for almost shooting you.
Nah, you're doing what you thought was right. You're protecting your home. No need to apologize for that. Just taking care of the people you love.
I was just worried about Sam. I get a bad feeling every time she leaves the house.
You're Sam's girlfriend. You're not Greg's girlfriend at all.
That's more than I like to admit.
If I don't get shot at, then
I
wasted the day.
A great shot.
So you weren't aiming for my feet? I was aiming for your head.
Oh. A patch of dirt. His mom's buried there.
Apparently she's...
You're so back, she just...
Yeah, I understand the feeling. Sick. It's not crossed Michonne's mind once or twice. Didn't want to be a burden on the people around her any longer, so she ended her suffering and ended their suffering at the same time.
She couldn't handle it, I guess. I never understood that. We were safe here.
Those poor children.
John told them she died in her sleep. Tried to spare them.
Sometimes when you sleep, you hear a very loud gunshot. Or bang noise. It sounds like a gunshot, but it's not. It's your heart breaking. Breaking so hard that it rings throughout the house. And leaves your brains on the wall next to you.
No.
It would have been better just to...
I just need more time. More.
You know, do it out an open window. Yeah, would that...
No. No.
I'm here, Sam. Hey, don't move, okay? Don't move. Sam, no.
You don't, bitch. Why you never listen? Hey.
So we have to help him.
Who? Or.
You're too weak. Pull me up. Just stay down, Sam.
I need to help him.
You're hallucinating, Sam.
I.
Greg isn't here, okay?
You know that.
Sam.
You're having a bad dream. And even when you wake up, it doesn't get any better. It just gets that much worse. Shouldn't you people be wet from being out in the rain? I know, you know, condensation is hard.
I know John can make a strong first impression. But he's what's keeping this entire family from being buried out there.
Well, he's not doing a great job.
You gotta fight like hell for what you care about, right?
Apparently you're all starving to death, or going to starve to death, and...
Something that makes all this shit worth it.
Keep on fighting.
Fight until the day you die.
Keep on rolling, baby. Oh, yeah.
You'd be crazy to stay here, John. This woman Norma
will... There's no decision to be made on this.
It's just giving you a heads up. Oh, me, huh? All right. Pete, what'd you say? What'd you tell him? No? All right, then. I'll bring my machete. I need to clean it off in the rain anyways. And, yeah, there we go. I'm like, Pete has nothing to say. I have no... I don't control Pete. This is Michonne's story, for God's sakes. So, how you doing? I hate the rain. Always shitty times in the rain, especially with my cut-off sleeve jacket. It doesn't hinder any of my movements, makes me actually a bit better of a swordsman, but...
Do you have children?
I do, I did, I do, I so, did.
A daughter?
I do. Two little girls.
We're just going to have a heart-to-heart here. No need to be aggressive, shitty. Your wife. She was brave, but she was also a massive coward at the same time.
It snowed the day my wife died. Her heart gave out. Sam found her. She passed in her sleep.
So it's a lie that you decide to believe in.
The snow. It covered her grave. Erased it. Like she'd never been there at all.
I'm really sorry for your loss.
No need to stir up waves.
I've tried to focus on our kids. But the past, it always seems to find you.
If you forget the past, you have a tendency to repeat it.
I've tried to keep our family from harm. But we're falling apart, piece by piece.
Yeah, seems like everybody everywhere else.
And Greg's. I could really use your help.
Motherfucker, you don't know me.
About what happened.
Mm-hmm.
If she finds us, we wouldn't stand a chance.
I think that's what Pete was trying to tell you.
Like someone who can hold their own.
I'm sorry, but our crew's still out there. I have to find them.
Please. Stay until morning.
Well, I'm not leaving in the night through the fucking woods. I don't know what argument you're trying to make here. There's a lot of shit outside there.
To see this.
Don't chuck you over the fence. Greg, just lob it.
Never turned into one of these things, did he? Are those, whatever they are.
He's at peace now.
Mm-hmm.
Thank God.
Yep. That's all you have to know. Yeah, just, no. Really? You gotta open the door? Can't just, okay, I was making fun of him for lobbing it over top the fence, but... Nah, just let him pour his heart out to a woman right now.
I'm sorry. I'm trying to keep it together. But what if you just found out your daughters were dead?
Hey, man, you should maybe close the... yeah. You should close the door.
And you weren't there.
Well...
You were miles away, safe and sound. How would you feel?
Your kids need you to stay strong.
You're right.
You have to set an example. Wow! Woo! Holy shit! Holy fuck! Wow! You didn't even know who that dude was. You blew his fucking face off. Holy shit! My goodness, that was impressive. You need to get the fuck down. You need to get down. That gunshot mean bad things coming. Bad things are here. The zombies have come, the walkers have,
No.
Okay, can... Think of it. No, attack this son of a bitch. Take the one that's unarmed with a flashlight. Although going after the one with the gun would probably have been a better idea, but the... Oh, that's just dumb luck right there. Get him before he screams. Oh, he's fucking tough too. He got stabbed in the leg, stabbed in the back, and he's still putting up a fucking significant... Four. Wow! That'll haunt your dreams for the remainder of your days. Holy fucking shit. Pete, get down. Wow! Uh-oh. Shit. You're unpleasant everywhere you go. My machete! Oh, fuck. Okay, fucker. You're outnumbered and you got a bad time coming towards you now. Oh, yeah. I can't mess up any of these prompts. Because I gotta beat the shit out of this guy all morning long. Uh-huh. How are we gonna do this about? Come on. Give me a prompt to fight back with. Shovel! Damn, this son of a bitch tough. Oh! Oh, don't worry. Don't worry, my son will be taking care of you real nice, like. Oh, that's a broken arm. Holy fuck. Oh! Or maybe just a dislocation of the arm. Please, stop being so much of an asshole. If I had a hammer, I'd fucking crush his hand. Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Oh, fuck. Yes. Oh, fuck. Wow. Holy fuck.
You all right?
Not dead yet.
Oh, that's a good line. She's gonna pop it back in? Oh, no, fucked up. Fucked up that prompt. All right, let's go for this again. This is gonna look real cool if I get it right. Whop! All right. Oh, I thought that was one of the kids with the machete, and it's like, Hello, fucker. You sure chased us a long way. And you've caused a lot of trouble.
Shit. You must be pretty proud of yourself, huh?
I'm gonna cut your fucking tongue off.
Think I'm shitting any eggs. Forget it.
Jesus.
Whoa! You don't mess around.
Keep talking.
I like that.
Oh. How are we gonna play this?
How'd you find the house?
You know, I probably never would have. Except you left a trail of walker parts right to the front gate.
Well, we had to protect ourselves.
Like some fucked up fairy tale.
Yeah, they're like breadcrumbs.
Randall, are you getting
this? You, wanna get that for me?
I'm gonna tighten that vise again.
You don't check in, I'm sending everyone in that direction.
Shit. She sounds pissed.
Randall, pick up, goddammit.
You gonna answer?
Talk to her, Michonne. Don't make the same mistake again.
Where the hell are you?
Yeah!
Randall!
Tell her my hands are viced up, and I've swallowed a pint of my own blood.
Yeah.
Yeah, I ain't gonna trust him. I was gonna have him, but he's gonna talk shit. Oof.
I have your brother.
Michonne. I hope you were smart enough not to hurt him.
Oh, I haven't stopped yet.
Where's my brother?
Go on. Tell her. Don't spare any of the gory details.
I've got him here.
Then you better keep him there with no harm done. I want the truth on this. You hear me? Did you hurt him?
Oh, yeah.
On my brother, I'll find you and make what happened on the ferry look like a goddamn picnic.
Randall shot an innocent man in the head. Anything I did to him, he deserved.
What Randall did, that was a mistake. And I'll make sure he knows it. But I'll punish him, not you. Okay.
Bitch, you better change your tone. Well, you're the only one wound up around here.
We had his walkie-talkie the whole time, and you already know. We heard the shots. We know where you are. But if you let Randall go, maybe we can all walk away.
Maybe.
Randall is the only family I have, and I'm not leaving him behind.
Oh.
One way or the other.
You know how this is going to turn out.
Together, then we can work something out. It's up to him.
Reasonable, Michonne.
Oh, I'm being reasonable. It's all about the unreasonableness of your brother. Alright. Then we'll sort it out.
This alone time, you and me together, it's been real nice. But that all ends when my sister gets here. I'm gonna take that wrench and break your skull. Then Sam's.
This wrench right here.
At least. Those kitties, too.
Threatening children in front of Michonne. It's gonna be hard.
You know, their skulls don't break so much as kind of melt like a rotted pumpkin.
It's gonna be hard to hold a wrench when you have no fingers. No.
Hey now. Don't you two look like your daddy? Back when he still had a face.
Told you to behave yourself, boy.
What?
Told you to behave yourself.
Big hole there now.
Oh, Randall, you're so tough.
Is that true?
You're so proud, ain't you?
Please tell me.
No, I'll let you know. truth.
Randall murdered your dad, Sam.
That's all basis on truth. I feel real bad. He seems broken up about it, too. He's sure that he's gonna crack our skulls in with a wrench. He just threatened to kill us all.
Then why isn't this son of a bitch dead?
First good question asked all night. Michonne's just been fumbling around like a bear cub fucking a football.
Randall has more value if he's alive. Gives us something to bargain with when Norma gets
here. Listen to me! That won't work! They only bargain with bullets.
All she wants is her brother back. That's it.
No. She wants blood. We fucked up her camp real good.
Sam, wait!
Oh.
No matter what I say, you're just gonna do whatever you want anyway.
Yeah, pretty much. I kind of really have, haven't I? Is it that obvious? Is it that transparent?
I ain't had the bell of the ball.
Yeah, well, Belle had prettier hands.
Because when this dance is over, you're fucked.
No.
Kill me, and Norma hunts you down until you're all dead. Fucked! Let me live, and I do even worse. Fucked.
How about...
how this is gonna end.
I just kill you all. There's a lot of...
And you'd like killing me. Just tell old Randall the truth. I got thick skin. You won't hurt my feelings.
You're right about that.
Feels good to get that out in the open, don't it?
Nah, it's always been known.
Maybe you think you can rise above all that.
Nah, I don't believe I can.
There ain't no heaven up there, honey. And there ain't no hell down below.
Well, if there is, it's not much better.
Every day until you die.
I think I'm gonna throw you out to the walkers.
You get up and keep walking. Now that is some biblical shit, ain't it?
He doesn't have a point.
Nothing we can do to change it.
He's just talking.
Fucking choir.
He's just making noise. Getting out his last rites.
This is the world your kids are dying in, Michonne.
Oh. Well. Rough time to be having a bit of a mental break.
Or are in that fucking purgatory. Shut up.
Michonne, hold up. We're gonna get a binary choice here.
They're suffering.
Yeah, I know which way I'm going.
And Mommy isn't there. We all have our demons, honey. Some are on the inside. Some are sitting right in front of us, wondering what kind of mother brings a child into this mess of a world.
Oh, I'm not Dan torturing you, boy. I'll kill you later. Don't you worry. But first, we're gonna have some fun.
Guess that means
dance has just begun.
Norma will be here soon.
And you can get to watch her die, too. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, they're really, really pushing for it. Really want me to kill that motherfucker right there, but there are worse things in this world than death. Interesting how the previous chapter preview, it was like, oh, you and Randall in a boat. And you have him... well, did I actually have him in the boat, or did I just mistake that garage for a boat? Interesting on how sometimes they plan for things and they don't get to it till about two chapters later, depending on how things play out.
I spent a lot of time in low places.
Man. Killing that father, that was some unexpected shit. Real nasty.
Believe me, they don't.
War's coming.
Things always fall apart. But we're the ones who bring them down.
Next time, things get better. Episode 2, Give Noah Shelter. Did you keep Pete with you or let him go off on his own? You and 82.1% of players stopped Pete. Wow, majority there. Did you pick up the phone after going after the footsteps in the hallway? You and 73.1% of players picked up the phone. Yeah, it made sense. Did you reveal to Paige that you nearly committed suicide? You and 23.8% of players expressed sympathy for the kids. Wow, major minority there. How did you handle the radio call from Norma? You and a minority of 35.7% of players picked up the radio and spoke with her directly. Oh, just looking for the truth on that. And what did you do to Randall? Wow, this is the closest split. And I like that it's like that. You and 47.4% of players showed him mercy. The minority there, most people went for it. And I had a feeling that most people went for that. But man, that didn't 100% fuel my decision behind that. No, I had a feeling that can have a lot more fun with that piece of shit by keeping him alive. Now, it really depends on how much they emphasized on that branching path there, especially with one more chapter remaining. This was like a short one. This was not really as short as like 400 days, but then again, with the overall time that this Michonne episodic ends up taking, you know, it's supposed to be about an hour and a half per, but this one barely took over an hour. I imagine that maybe the last chapter might be an hour and a half as well. There, 400 days, that was over 3 hours, if I'm not mistaken. That was one of the longer chapters, just because the different stories and the paths and the branches that you could have gone upon. But man, this, good set pieces, very good set pieces. Hell, with a good bit of tinkering as well, the game actually ran real fucking solid. I was amazed. It was only during the transition periods where it would drop between below 60 FPS, where, hell, the first episode, I was lucky if it would stay above 50 most of the time, so quite happy about that. Good change in performance, or a bit of stabilization, but that was due to my own little tinkering, moving it over to the SSD, adjusting a few settings here and there. But there you go, there you have it. Another Garrett. There you go, there you have it. Garrett plays with himself in The Walking Dead Michonne. Next time, What We Deserve, Episode 3. And as always, take her easy.